Topic for today is thyroid carcinoma. There are four types of thyroid carcinoma. The papillary carcinoma, which is present in the 85% of cases. The follicular carcinoma, which is present in the 5 to 15% of cases. Medullary thyroid carcinoma and the anaplastic carcinomas. Now comes to the papillary carcinoma. What is the pathogenesis behind the papillary carcinoma? The mutation in RET gene, which is present on the 10th chromosome, which encodes the tyrosine kinase. If there is a paracentric inversion of the chromosome 10 or the reciprocal translocation between the chromosome 10 and the 17, there will be a gain of function in the RET gene, results in the overfunctioning of the tyrosine kinase. The translocation between the 10th chromosome and the 17th chromosome result in the formation of the novel gene RET-PTC. PTC is a parathyroid carcinoma associated gene type 1 and type 2. It expressed in the thyroid epithelium. It's present in 20 to 40% of cases. It's associated with the sporadic papillary carcinoma. Radiation exposure increases the risk. Another gene involved is NTRK1, which is present on the first chromosome. There is also the paracentric inversion, and the translocation leads to the gain of function in NTRK1. Other gene involved is the BRAF, which is a component of the MAP kinase pathway, mitotic activated protein kinase pathway, in which the villein is replaced by the glutamate in the codon 600, which result in the gain of function, and the gain of function will result in the adverse prognostic effect. Means if there is a gain of function mutation in the BRAF, it results in the metastasis and extra thyroidal extension. BRAF is also associated with other tumors like melanomas, hairy cell leukemia, colon cancers. What are the risk factors associated with the papillary carcinoma? Ionizing radiations are associated with the papillary carcinoma. It's present in 85% of cases, and the age risk factor for papillary carcinoma should be 25 to 50 years of age. Now comes to the morphology of the papillary carcinoma. Grossly, what we will see? We will see the solitary or the multifocal nodules, well circumscribed, infiltrative, and ill-defined margin, because it's a malignant tumor, not the benign tumor. Therefore, it's the infiltrative and has the ill-defined margins. What microscopic features can we see? Branching papillae. Means it has got the appearance finger-like projections. This is the tumor. It has got finger-like projections like this. And the cells having the ground glass or the orphan eye nuclei means the cells will be optically clear, empty appearance due to dispersed chromatin. These are the simple cuboidal epithelium. It has got the clear appearance because the chromatin inside these cells has got dispersed. It has got the seminoma bodies, mean the centrically calcified structure. This is the papillae. This is the single papillae, means this part. This is single papillae, which has got the fibrous vascular stalk through which it's connected to the outer capsule, because it's an encapsulated structure. This is central calcification area, is known as seminoma bodies, and this is a cuboidal epithelium surrounding it, and this cuboidal epithelium has got the ground glass or the orphan eye nuclei. There is also the foci of the lymphatic invasions are also present, but there is no evidence of the hematogenesis spread. There are four histological variants of the papillary carcinoma. The number one is the follicular variant, the tall cell variant, papillary microcarcinoma, and the diffuse sclerosing variant. First of all, come to the follicular variant. Nuclear features of the papillary carcinoma will be present, but the architecture of the follicular variant will be like a follicular, muscles. It has got the angioinvasive spread. It's maybe because it's encapsulated. If it's encapsulated, it has got the favorable prognosis. But if it's poorly circumscribed or infiltrative, it has got the poor prognosis. It has got the hematogenous spread, but the low incidence of the lymph node metastasis. What mutations can be involved in the follicular variant of the papillary carcinoma? RETPTC, BRAF, but it has got the low incidence, and the RAS has got the increased incidence. Now come to the tall cell variant. Simply, this will be same as the papillary carcinoma, but this is the variant, and these cells becomes tall, like this. It has got the xenophilic cytoplasm. It also got the vascular invasion, extra thyroid extension, and the cervical and the distant metastasis. But in the follicular variant, there was only vascular invasion present, not the extra thyroid extension and the cervical distant metastasis. It has got the aggressive behavior. What mutations can be involved? BRAF and RETPTC. It's present in the older individuals, but there is no evidence of the RAS mutation. Now come to the papillary microcarcinoma. It has got similar appearance to the papillary carcinoma, but it should be less than 1 cm. Now comes to the diffuse sclerosing variant of the papillary carcinoma. It has got the papillary growth pattern, but has got the intermixed areas of the squamous metaplasia, means similar. This cuboidal epithelium will be present, but in the some areas like this will be squamous metaplasia will be present, or there will be a extensive diffuse fibrosis. There will be a lymphocytic infiltration there, which has got the stimulation for the formation of Hashimoto's thyroiditis. There will be a mutations only in the RET and PTC. These are present in the younger children, but the tall cell variant will present in the older individuals. Now comes to the clinical features of the papillary carcinoma. Asymptomatic thyroid nodule will be present. There will be a mass in the cervical lymph nodes. If the thyroid nodule is large enough, it can cause the hoarseness in the voice, dysphagia, cough, and dyspnea. If it has got the hematogenous spread like the follicular variant or the tall cell variant, it will go to the lungs and cause the metastasis. What are the diagnostic criteria for the papillary carcinoma? We can do the radionuclide scanning, CT scans, on which we can see the cold nodules, means the radioactive iodines are not taken more by the parenchymal cells. Malignant cells. We can do the fine needle aspiration cytology. And what can be the prognosis? Prognosis depend on the age, extra thyroidal extension, distant metastasis. For example, if it's the tall cell variant, it has got the extra thyroidal extension, as well as it's present in the older individuals, it has got the aggressive behavior. This means it has got the bad prognosis. But if I talk about the other variants, it has got the excellent prognosis. 10-year survival rate can be 95%.